Hi friends, welcome back to React.js 0 to Hero series. This series is for beginners who wants to learn React.js from scratch. In the last video, I have explained about props. So ideally, I have to explain about states in this video. But I thought of explaining about handling events in React because it will help us to understand states easily. So in this video, I'm going to explain about handling events in React. Let's start. Events are actions or occurrences that happen in the system. In HTML, there are various events which represents that some activity is performed by the user or by the browser. For example, if the user clicks a button on a web page, we might want to react to that event by hiding or showing something. This process of reacting over the events is called event handling. JavaScript handles the HTML events through event handlers. There are many events available in JavaScript. For example, we have click event, mouse over, mouse leave, change event, input event, etc., in which click event and change event are most oftenly used events. Let me show you how we can use events in React. I have created a new application in which I have created a button. So when I preview, we can see this. On clicking this button, let's show an alert. If it is plain JavaScript, we can use the onClick event handler like this. But as it is JSX, we have seen we need to use camel case. And so here, we need to use capital C like this. First, let me create a function which display an alert. And here, I can use the function inside curly braces in this event handler. And so, if I click the button, we can see the alert is getting displayed. An important thing to note here is, we should not call the function here like this. If you do that, the function will be called during the page load itself. So instead of calling the function, we need to just have the function name. In that case, assume I need to call a function which is accepting some parameters. How can we pass the values to these parameters? To find that, we need to know the other way of calling the function. Let me create another function. This time, I'm going to create an arrow function. And I can create another button and use this function. So when I click, we can see this is working. I can further simplify this arrow function to be on one line. This will also work. And here, instead of this, now I can use this directly. We can see this is still working. But here, we are calling the inbuilt JavaScript alert function to which we are passing some values. And so we can either use this way to call a function or we can rewrite to use it like this. Similar to that, even to our own function, which accepts parameter, we can call like this and pass the value to the parameter. Okay, next let's see how we can get the value from a text box. First, let me create an input box. Now I can use the onChange event to trigger a function. Inside this function, let me put a console log. So that when we type, we can see the console log. Now, to get the value of the input box, I can access the event. So let me comment this and console log the event. Now if I type, we can see the event. And so I can use event.target.value to get the value of the input box. Like this. So now we can see the actual input value in the console. I hope you understood how we can handle events in React. Before we close, let me show you one more thing. Let me create a new variable called count, which I am initializing into 0. And let me show that variable in the UI. Now let me create a function. And inside that function, let me increase this count. And let me also create a button and call this function on clicking the button. So I'm expecting to increase this count whenever the button is clicked. But this is not working. Let me put a console log inside the function and see whether the count is actually increasing. We can see the count is getting increased, but it is not reflecting in the UI. Any idea why it is behaving like that? There comes the concept of states in React, and that is what I'm going to explain in my next video. Okay, you can try this task. You can create two divs and apply some inline styles so that it should look like this. Now, when you move your mouse over to this first div, it should throw an alert like this. And when you move your mouse to the second div, it should throw an alert like this. Try this. If you need the solution code, you can get it from this GitHub repo. The link is available in the description. That's all for today. Please like this video, subscribe my channel, and support me. Thank you. Bye.